go that, go that, go that, go that, go that. Please, please don't go that, go that, go that, go that, go that, go that with me. Left wrist go that, right wrist go that, neck this go that, sis go that, this go that, go that, go that, go that, go that, go that, go that with me.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Tennessee Titans taking on the Houston Texans. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
From the set.
They'll start on the ground with Pierce. Down the numbers. There he goes. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
Well, they didn't do a lot there to fool anyone. They just came right out and ran the football, but with great success, and that's the way you want to get things started. A nice quick opener for a big game.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. And they'll go play action here with Stroud. And his throw here is incomplete. The Texans are 1-1 through two games thus far. It's not a start that's going to set the world on fire, but they've been pretty solid nonetheless.
And the first thing that crosses my mind, it certainly beats the alternative of starting 0-2. I do think that this is a team that's going to take a little time to find its footing. Hard to navigate the always tough NFL.
On the ready.
Now a second and 10.
Ready.
Now Stroud. Flush to his right. His throw incomplete. Damian Pierce, his intended target, out of the backfield. And that takes us from second to third down. You talk about this Titan defense, and they've been excellent against the pass, the number six unit in the NFL.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through for a solid game.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
From the 23, here's second and a couple. Stroud out of the gun here. And that's going to be incomplete. Not the warmest starts throwing the football. He was 1-for-3, now 1-for-4 on the opening drive.
So getting him comfortable is the key. And for him, it might be different than what we think is comfortable. We're probably thinking swing passes, easy checkdowns. Some guys, they're better off throwing it downfield. That's what really loosens them up.
Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down.
Cut 19! Cut 19!
Go! Stroud working out of the gun. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down. And he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and two. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
That is caught at the 7-yard line. And the Texans are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. Here goes Stroud again. Eluding the pressure right. And it is caught. Touchdown, Texans. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Texans will jump on top of the game's first score here this afternoon. Building confidence after a loss, that's a good way to do it. The loss last game, but first drive here in this one, cashing it in for 6.
And they can talk all they want about putting the loss behind them. I think that drive there did more than any conversation they had, don't you think?
That's exactly right. Puts that to bed. And this is what they said all week long. A lot of things they needed to do differently. But whatever they said appears to have worked. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. First and 10 now, Willis and the Titans at their own 23. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Here's Willis. Gets this to the former Texan, DeAndre Hopkins. DeAndre Hopkins, touchdown Titans. DeAndre Hopkins, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Titans are able to strike back quickly with an opening touchdown of their own. But Charles, here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. That looked like a well-designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon. A player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
Michael Bassley set to kick off. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda. Inside the 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think they, were they a nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did and came through with a big-time pick six.
Badgley on for the extra point. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Now here's a handoff out of the gun, and he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's second down and five. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Play action. Here's Stroud. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda, down to the 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, CD, that's a huge play by this defense in a close ball game. I think he was trying to just extend the play there, getting outside the pocket, but he throws a costly pick six.
Yeah, he's trying to find someone open. You're exactly right. He wasn't looking to run. He was looking to throw. The result, not good for him. They were more than happy on the defensive side to gather that one in and take it to the house.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it's now 21-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here we go. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And not the first time that they're coming back out off of a turnover, but the last one really hurt Charles with that pick six.
And it feels like the whole team's infected right now, doesn't it? It's not just been one person. It's kind of been a group effort where the mistakes have happened. Can they put that aside, kind of start over, and put together a nice drive?
So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. A shotgun snap to Stroud. He's got his man. It's the tight end, Brevin Jordan. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now they'll throw it with Stroud here, first and 10. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Here's second and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Back to throw. Here's Stroud. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. On second down, here's Pierce. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
Let's go.
A pretty wild first quarter. 21-7, our score. Ready for the second quarter from Houston. It's the Texans in possession of the football, as they'll see what they can do on third and goal.
On the jump. 70 Ranger. 70 Ranger.
Stroud to throw it. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Take down. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans are back within a score. On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbear. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbear now to kick it away. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Come on.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Okay, didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
3rd and 2, Willis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred a defense.
And Henry going to have a Titans first down as he's across midfield to the 48.
Ready.
They'll run it again with Henry. And trying to push forward, but he is going to be stuffed up in the backfield. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
At the Texans 49-yard line.
18, 5 here.
Steady. Back to throw, Willis. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. Give him 6 yards and the first down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Henry out of the pistol. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
From the 32-yard line now, here's a second and 9. Willis looks to pass it here. That ball caught by Campbell. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down.
Boy, everything clicking on this drive. He's 4 for 4 now, and that throw, maybe the best of the bunch. This offense is really humming, and they pick up another first down.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. On the counter, it's Henry. And he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. They'll get it forward to him on the touch pass. And a great job there to read that one defensively. They strung him out, would not allow him to cut off field.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Here is 3rd and 5. Now Willis to throw. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
Oh, Brandon, that's a gamer move right there. Facing third down, steps up, calls his own number, and nearly makes the house call. If I'm the coach, I let him take another one right here. Give him a chance to be the first one to hit the end zone after that effort he just gave him.
Henry will score. Touchdown, Tennessee.
You think back to some of the great goal line bruisers of the past, the Earl Campbells, the John Riggins, the Marshawn Lynches. And then you can put Derrick Henry right in that group as he scores there with another patented Derrick Henry run.
Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Stroud now on first and 10.
Flushed out right. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Collins. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Nothing, 19.
Stroud. That is caught by Dell. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. He got 29 yards that time.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
Come on.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Throwing now is Stroud. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal.
60 bison. Go!
And he'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. This defense hasn't let them in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. Third and goal from the 2.
79 Broncos.
Ready. And Stroud now to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. C.J. Stroud in the final seconds of the first half. And the Texans are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half.
Hey, you're down on the scoreboard, but now your offense is in close, and this is where, as a quarterback, you say, I've got to make a play here. Doesn't matter whether it's a pinpoint throw or a scramble like this one. He takes matters into his own hands and delivers a touchdown run.
So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And with only 4 seconds on the clock, time likely for just one snap of the football. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Titans offense set to begin the drive. We've got a close game. The offense has played well, but right now, they've got to keep their foot on the gas.
And that carries with it an extra bit of pressure, doesn't it? As much fun as they're having right now, they're locked in, really clicking on all cylinders. They also know that if they ever miss a chance to put points on the board, they've actually put their team in jeopardy. And that's not how you want to play the game. It's supposed to be complementary football, offense, defense. But today, it's all offense for them.
Yeah, they've been playing with a sense of urgency. It's probably going to need to continue.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Trying to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Christian Harris, and they will take over at the 26-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
A great play there with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Texans take the forced turnover on defense and convert it into 6 points. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And we are all tied at 28. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. We got a brand new ball game, all even after that last touchdown, so every drive now becoming a little more critical here in the second half. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Henry again on second down. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does.
Here you go.
It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL.
Ready.
And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
And this one not going anywhere. They get him at the 44 for a gain of just 1 yard.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job.
And no way to run for Willis. He goes down. It'll go as a loss of 3 on the sack, and it brings up third down. Well, on that one, they go to the play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You've got to sell the run action. Otherwise, why do you stop at the running back? You just run straight for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of words in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
First down, they go right back to Pierce. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
He's got exactly what you're looking for, the ability to not just diagnose a play and quickly, but to make a play as well. Nice job there tackling him for a loss.
Alert!
And they'll go right back to Pierce. And a solid run here as a pick is run down to the 42-yard line. 70 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Offensive line right now really freeing up the rushing lanes on this drive.
And we have to give them props. They've earned them. But these big runs that we're seeing, they don't result without everyone else being involved as well. Blocking on the perimeter has to take place downfield too.
Short throw into the hands of Jordan. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that's going to bring up second down.
Hey, let's face it. You can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
And he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line.
Well, praise has to go to the guys in the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Stroud now on 3rd and 2. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's going to have the Texans first down as they get 5 there on 3rd and 2.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Caught left side, here's Dill. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Here we go, Scott!
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 10.
Check, check.
Hand off left side, Pierce. And he'll take this one down near the 15. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
This offense on third down today, no problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. This is 3rd and 9. Going for it with Pierce. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that.
He needed 9. He got 8. And that's going to leave him with a 4th and 1 on their side of the field.
A return from the middle of the end zone, and that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Titans offense set to begin the drive. The pressure is on now. They're being shut out here in the second half after a decent first half offensively. And they need their best drive of the game right here. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right of the yard.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
And we'll get it. He's been busy today. And he tries to power forward, but he will not get back to the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
With this size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
On 2nd down, here's Henry. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
Shreds him with a stiff arm.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. And even 100 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Well, now a designed run for Ridley. They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because this message can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss. Willis looking to throw it. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Christian Harris. And the Texans are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
All right, Brandon. Normally when you hear about guys making 2 interceptions in the game, you're thinking, must be a free safety, maybe a corner. How about getting 2 picks out of one of your linebackers? Again, he's just in the right place at the right time. And that's another great play to come away with the football.
Steps up here and down he goes.
That's Azeez Al-Shaair getting through for the sack that time.
Now how about that? Defensive coordinator perfectly in sync, dials up a blitz, and the man in the middle, he's the one who gets home.
Big Mike.
Big Mike.
Stroud sets up the play action. Swings this one out wide for Pierce. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Stroud off the play fake. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
These guys are running offense that you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football.
Hawk 70, Hawk 70. 19 tight, 19 tight. Go.
That one looks like he'll throw here. He finds his man, complete. It's back.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
Second and 3 with the ball sitting on the 5.
Ready.
A give left side for Pierce. And he's in for the score. Touchdown, Texans. Damian Pierce, his third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Texans look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. This is first and 10. Throwing, Willis. Under pressure and down he goes. That was Will Anderson getting home and finishing the play. And that sack, Charles, just looked like a case where a speedy defensive end is a little bit quicker than the offensive tackle.
Yeah, it makes it difficult for a tackle to determine what exactly to do. Do you do the kick slide and try and get back in the pocket and meet him there? Do you meet him on the line of scrimmage where they call a quick set? In any event, right now, he's having his troubles.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Okay, great.
This crowd turning up the decibel level. It's third and long. A 20th carry now for Derrick Henry.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
All three timeouts still remain. Keep that in mind. They'd prefer to use him on the defensive end. But here's first and 10. At 5 yards, not going to cut it here. That clock continues to run.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
And this is going to be a Titans first down as good running gets them to about the 44. Well, this was a fun